Hello everyone and welcome to this session of programming with Python. So in the previous session we saw the concept of object oriented programming, and in this session we will see how do we create objects in Python. So the creation of the object start with the creation of any classes. So to create an object we have to first understand what do we mean by classes in Python. So classes basically tells us what kind of attribute will define our object or what kind of behavior it would follow. For example, let's say we have a car. Now if we define car as a class, then every car, no matter what brand it is or which year it is launched, every car will have a four wheel, will have some seating capacity and would have a color. But when we say that car has a black color, it can accommodate 6 people and the brand is BMW, then this car is an object of a class called car. So classes are basically the general definition which would be same throughout it every object. For example, every car will have four wheel, will be used to go from point A to B and would have some seating capacity. So let's take another example. Suppose we have a store, and store is consisting of different kinds of items, and each item has price, quantity, name and a kind of behavior. Now if we want to define the every item of the store, then we need to create a class called item, and every item will have an attribute of price and quantity, it would have a name and it would have a behavior. So if we define the first object, let's say phone, to the item class, then we will define its price and quantity. So let's say the price of every phone is 100 and the quantity is 50, and the behavior would be the total price. So if we multiply 150, we will get 5000. And let's say we take another item, let's say shoe, and if we define shoe as a object of the item class, then we will again define the price and quantity, let's say 50 and 200, and the behavior would be 10,000, which we would get by multiplying the 50 and 200. So these object 1 and object 2, here object 2 should be written, are the instances of this class item. So this is how we create an object in Python. So now to create an object, we use class keyword. So let's head over to Python and understand this in detail. So to create a class, we first write the class keyword, followed by our name of class, which is item in our case. Afterward, let's say we don't give it any code right now and we write class. Now if we want to create an object of this class, then first we will write the name of our variable in which our item will be stored. So we will write item 1 followed by the name of our class and parentheses. So now we have created an object of the class item. Now if we want to give attributes such as name, quantity and price, then we will say that item 1 dot name is phone, item 1 dot quantity is 50 or let's say 100, and item 1 dot price is 50. So as you can clearly see that now we have created an object called phone, which is a object of the class item, and the attributes are its name, quantity and price. The name is phone, the quantity is 100 and the price is 50. Similarly, we can create another item like item 2. We have to equate it to the class, that is item, followed by we will give the different attributes item 2 have. So let's say item 2 dot name is equals to shoes, item 2 dot quantity is equals to 200, and item 2 dot price is equals to 50. Now we have created two different item of the or two different object of the same class item. Now to verify it that we have created an object, we can find the type of these attributes. So we will write type item 1 dot quantity, and if I run this I get an int, because item 1 dot quantity is storing an integer value. Similarly, if I replace item 2 dot name, then I get an str value or string value, because item 2 dot name is storing shoes, which is a string in nature. So this is how we create an class in Python and create an object of that classes. Now, as you can clearly see that every time we have to write the name of our different attributes and write it different values. So it will become very cumbersome process if the number of items are in 100. So how can we go around it? So Python basically provides us a initializer function to automatically create the common attribute such as name, price, quantity, and every time we instantiate or create an object of our class. So this initializer function is known as init method, and it is written as to underscore followed by init followed by to underscore, and within the parameter we pass a mandatory parameter of self. This self represent the object which we are instantiating. So every time we will create our object by equating it to a class, then class will call this initializer function, and the self within this initializer function would be replaced by the name of the variable in which our object is stored. Similarly, the other parameters that will be given to our initializer function would be the common attributes we want to automatically give our object as we instantiate it. So let's head over to Python and understand this in detail. So as we were defining our class item, there in the outside of our class we were defining the different attributes, namely name, quantity and price, but we had to create every time we instantiate an object. For example, when we created item 1, we had to write item 1 dot name, item 1 dot quantity, item 1 dot price. Similarly, when we created item 2, we again had to say item 2 dot name, item 2 dot quantity, item 2 dot price. So we can go around it by using our initializer function. So we will first write the name of our initializer function, that is def, followed by double underscore init double underscore, and within we write first the self. This self would be replaced by the name of the variable in which our item is stored, and it will be replaced by the name of the variable every time we will instantiate our object, followed by we will write the name of the argument which we want to automatically instantiate, that were the name, price and quantity. So we will write name, price and quantity. Now we will define the attributes we want with our object. So the attributes we wanted were self.name, self.price and self.quantity. And what we wanted to store in these? We wanted to store the name of our product, we wanted to store the price of our product, and we wanted to store the quantity of our product. So to avoid confusion, let's say we replace name, price and quantity by n, p and q. So this initializer function, as it would be called, then it will create three different kinds of attribute, namely name, price and quantity, and it will store the value that would be n, p and q, that would be given as we instantiate our object. Now if we create the behavior of our class item, so we will write define total price followed by self. As we explained earlier that this self would be replaced by the object, in which our the variable in which our object is stored, and since we want it to return the total price, we will write return self dot price multiplied by self dot quantity. So now if I have to instantiate again my object, then I will write item 1 is equals to item that it belongs to class item, followed by its name, that is n, the name is phone, the price was 100 and the quantity is 50. And now I want to calculate the total price, so I will write item 1 dot self total price followed by the parentheses. And now if I run this, I think we are getting an error. Item 1 dot total price, sorry, we forgot underscore here. Now if I run this again, we get 5000 as an output, because this total price will replace the self with the item 1 or the variable in which the phone is stored, and it will replace the self dot price with the price we passed during the item instantiation, and the self dot quantity will be replaced by the same, that is 50 here, and it will return the value of 5000. So that's how we create classes and instantiated object in our Python programming. Now in the next session we will see how can different classes inherit different properties. So that would be the concept of inheritance. So that's all for this session. Thank you.